Hello everyone and welcome back to the next video we have. And this video we are going to see about the combination of resistors. It's in the combination of both series as well as parallel, right? And we take three different resistors, and in that resistors, two resistors is connected in parallel, and those two resistors connected in parallel, and that was connected with one more resistor which is in connected with series, right? Now we are directly move on to first demo, right? So here I'm going to take some little bit toys to demonstrate the connection between these resistors. Okay, yeah, so look at this toys. Consider this is one resistor. Okay, now we have the second resistor. Okay, we have the second resistor. So series connection, the sense, so this is series connection, right? Yes, so here I can use this one. Yeah, this is called, we are saying that new series connection, right? Yes, this is called series in connection. Yes, so this arm is connected here and this arm is connected here, and likewise it will go. And this is two resistor, and here we are going to do the third resistor here. Yes, I'm going to place over the third resistor on that second resistor. Okay, yes, otherwise better I can, yes, okay, no, yes, yes. Okay, so these two resistors are connected in parallel, and the set of this resistor is connected series with another one resistor. Is it clear? Yes. Now we move on to our problems. So moving on to our problem, here I have three different resistors, namely I marked as R1, R2, R3. So R2 and R3 are connected in parallel. So these two connection made connected with series connection with R1. Yes. So here we want to find out the total resistance between the point A to C. It's clear now? We want to find the total resistance between the point A and C. Okay. Whenever solving this kind of problem, check is there any parallel connection in that between the points. So here we have the parallel connection, right? So these two parallel connections, we know that the effective resistance between these two is 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, that is 1 by Rp, right? If you want to Rp, then we need to take reciprocal of that value, right? So this is a diagram. For the diagram, I am going to calculate total resistance value. R 1 to 3 stands for these three resistors. Okay, the total resistance 1 to 3 is indicating is equal to R1, yes, R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Why we are going to do like that? Because these two resistors are connected in parallel. So here I used 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 because of parallel connection, right? Once if it is parallel connection is evaluated or we are calculated, okay, then this circuit is going to connected with seriously with R1 resistor. So for that, for understanding, here I wrote after making is parallel, it will give effective resistance that becomes changed as R equivalent 2-3. So the resistance 2-3 will give equivalent resistor. So remember that here we have 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, that is 1 by R2-3 equivalent. Right, here I wrote 1 by R suffix equivalent and prefix 2-3, right, which is equal to 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Suppose if you want only R, that means the reciprocal of this value, if you want the sense, reciprocal, the sense, this is reciprocal right now, 1 by R2-3 equivalent. If you want only to find R2-3 equivalent in the sense, we need to take a reciprocal of this value, right? So here I did. So here if you are taking LCM, how it becomes R3 plus R2 whole divided by R2 R3, that is 1 by R. So here I want only R equivalency. So I am taking here R2, taking reciprocal of this one, R2 into R3 whole divided by R2 plus R3. And this is the total resistance after this parallel circuit is changed as here, right? And now this equivalent resistor and this R1 resistor is made a connection with series. So we need to add with series connection. So here I added R1 plus R2 R3 whole divided by R2 plus R3. Now we want to find out the total current passing through this circuit. Yes. So here the passing current I. As we know that in series current is constant and voltage is variable, right? So far the current is same up to the point B after this one, right? After that the current is going to be divided into I1 into I2 because of these two resistors are connected in parallel. And therefore what you are going to do in the sense, we are calculated the total resistance of this system, right? So current I is equal to V by the total resistance of resistor 1, 2, 3. That's why I wrote R to the power 1, 2, 3. So we found here the value of this R power 1, 2, 3. So substitute here. Okay. So here we have R1 plus whole bracket R2 plus R3. Sorry, R2 into R3 whole divided by R2 plus R3. Now take LCM between this factor and this factor. Here we have denominator 1. So just take LCM between this one and this one. We should multiply this term by here. Yes. So R1 into R2 plus R3 plus R2 into R3 whole divided by, we took LCM, right? Whole divided by R2 plus R3. So here we have numerator, here we have denominator. In that denominator, this is numerator, this is denominator. So denominator of denominator goes to numerator. So we can write this denominator of denominator goes to numerator. So I is equal to V into R2 plus R3 whole divided by this factor. So R1 into R2 plus R1 into R3 plus R2 into R3. And this is the total current passed through that circuit. I hope you understand well, very clearly.